Hello everyone, this is Zoltar and welcome to another episode of Darkest Dungeon. Today, we are going to be diving back into the ruins and search for some holy relics with the Dob, Gavstapo, Hellion 2, and Crusader 2, who should probably get names at some point, but aren't important enough right now. Let's get to it. I'm going to be taking, it's a medium run, I'm thinking we'll go with a pretty safe 16 food. Two shovels, plenty of torches as well. 8 hopefully will be a decent amount. I'm not going to worry so much about the anti-venom and the bandages, but a couple skeleton keys would do nicely. And probably going to go with a little holy water as well in case we hit some confession booths. Hope I didn't need more of that to actually succeed at the cleansing the relics thing. I didn't think about that. That would be kind of silly. But not all that out of character for the game. It does a poor job of explaining. Symbols.
Collect the scattered scraps of faith and give comfort to the masses.
Well, that's a good start. Okay, random assortment of skeletons. Hopefully this won't be too much of an issue. Let's just open with a breakthrough. Now, I think I'm going to throw out some dazzling light at the scary bone soldier. That's painful. Sad that Dob was so late in the queue for that stun, but not much to do about it. And Bump in the Night being the useless skill that it usually is. Of course, Zealous Accusation was even worse, so what am I saying?
Confidence.
That's better. That's more like it. And I think we'll go ahead and just finish you off with a nice cut.
A faint hope blossoms.
That's a little better, and go for the Stunning Blow. Just pull the usual heal up a little bit nonsense. You're stunned. Take that. And yeah, we can just go for the kill now. We got an extra heal out from that, so it's good enough. Got a warrior's cap, which could be good. Could be good on the Crusader, who we usually want to kind of push late. But we'll leave it off for now. I'm always concerned about equipping these items that have these negative effects. What are we scouting? Okay. Well, we're still going to fully explore. Just because I have a problem. Let's put it that way. I have to see everything, if I can pull it off. And what do we got? We can Dazzling Light if we really want to. The other option is to go for a Judgment, but that's unlikely to get a kill. Even if we do it. 3-7, it would have to crit. Crit chance is only 8%, so let's just go for the stun instead. Get out some damage reduction. I think here we'll actually... Yeah, let's stick to the breakthrough. That gets the kill anyway, so that's not bad. Ha! Take that, jerk. Nice. And we'll actually go for the stun, because there was only a decent chance of killing with Smite. This is a lot safer. And now we finish him. Easy stuff.
Remind yourself that
simple skeletons. Hopefully this run won't be too difficult. That was
killer.
Part of the point of it. Now I think we can do some of this. Aha!
Wealth beyond measure.
Money.
Awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike.
But yeah, we wanted an easy run here because part of the point of the run is to get the Dob and the Gavstapo up to level 3 so they can join the other two members of the main party in some medium level dungeons. And part of the point is to level up the Hellion and the Crusader a bit so they're a bit better equipped against the Swine Prince. since we can't use our main group on those bosses, I believe. Well, maybe we're able to, but they're kind of high level, and my understanding is they'll get upset and be like, no, I don't want to go on that mission. Too good for it. Okay, jerks. Okay, let's start with... we'll actually judge instead of going for any stuns. The hope here is that we get to break through.
A powerful blow.
That's very nice, that's very nice. Especially with the crit for the stress relief. Breakthrough for the kill here is the hope, and then we can toss out a Zealous Accusation and maybe take these two down. Excellent. Now we've just got the Arbalest left, and he's already stunned, so... is everybody full health? No? Let's fix that. Just toss out a basic heal. No reason not to, in my mind.
Trifling victory.
And our inventory is already full. Got all kinds of different stuff so far already. We'll equip the warrior's cap if it comes to that for clearing up inventory space. Okay, maybe there's a holy relic in here. Maybe we'll find out. Who do we want to check the books? We'll have the Hellion check the books. Because I also kind of want to keep these two low on stress, so they can go out right away if necessary. Okay. Now, I've heard, also, that you can bash these open with a shovel. So I'm going to try that, just see if it works. No item is open. Okay, this is a reliquary. It just looks like one of the cabinets. And of course it takes an inventory slot, why wouldn't it? I just get confused. See, I thought it was this. I thought it was a locked display cabinet and I can't read. It's all my fault. Yes, you can smash it open. That was not particularly good loot, though. Especially considering we did spend a shovel on it. So maybe we won't ever do that again. Especially if we have a key. But it was nice to try anyway and confirm that it works. Whole bunch of empty hallways. Well, fairly smooth sailing so far. I guess we can't complain about that. What do we got? Is that another holy relic? And more loot? I'm up for more loot and holy relics. Not gonna complain. I still wish it told you though if there was... ooh, excellent. No! This is why we brought holy water! And now look what you did. Now look what you did. What's your problem anyway? I don't even know. Was it... probably egomania. From the look of it. I just... We brought holy water. We brought holy water so we could, like, purge that and be like, stress relief! But no, we just had to get more stressed out by it because our people are crazy. There's a fight in here. They're surprised again. Whatever, I'll take it. Similar thing to last time, although we're actually going to judge here this time. Out the gas. Good stuff. Ah, we missed, but at least the gas hit earlier, so everything's working out okay anyway. Because those things terrify me. You do not in any way want to be hit by that tempting goblet. Horrible thing to have happen. Actually going to toss out this because I want the Crusader to take the stress relief. Yeah, there we go. Because the Hellion only had one stress. I mean, who cares?
They can be beaten.
Okay, we will take that. Take all. It takes. They don't stack. Okay, fine. Look, take the warrior's cap. Alright, that means I'll probably camp in this room here to clear out that inventory space. Is this just another reliquary? Just sitting here in the middle of nowhere? Alright, well I guess we're done with the quest now. Get rid of the jade then. That's still really annoying. That makes me not want to do these ever again, just because... Fine, we're tossing out the torches.
The light, the promise of safety. Yep.
Hellion, do it. Yep, you got trapped. Take that.
Cruel machinations spring to life with a singular purpose.
That means we won't actually camp quite yet. Because I want to explore the rest of the place. It's here to explore. We may as well see if we can find something we can take back. But man, taking up 3 inventory slots. That's awful. It's just awful. But yeah, I wanted to explore a little bit more before camping, just because it'll provide a light refresh on camp. Okay, there could be a battle in all of those rooms, for all we know. So we will go ahead and make camp here.
Circle in the dark. The battle may yet be won.
Stick to half rations, because we don't want to feast. Could put up a massive debuff, but it's not that big a deal. We'll just stick to the buffs for the time being. And what else do we got? What else do we got? We can do some encouraging. We can do some praying. Let's try some praying, actually. There we go. That's 25 stress relief from the prayer. And now we're out of time. And everybody except the Crusader has some serious stress resistance as well.
In
from
radiance,
his little speech.
May we find victory.
Okay. Well, let's start this way. I wonder if there's more than 3 holy relics, or if there are exactly 3 of them in this area. I could see it going either way. I don't actually know who's best at traps here. I used the Hellion earlier, but that was mostly from laziness. Probably the Plague Doctor, but I don't want him to do it, because he'll probably just get hit anyway. Okay, that's more of a fight. Let's lead with... an attempt at a stun here. It's unfortunate. This may not have been worth all the stress we're gonna have to deal with, but whatever. At least that blinding gas has been on point this run. I'd really love to go before the Bone Soldier. Okay. Didn't finish it. It was unlikely to, but thankfully Zealous Accusation can. And I think we should actually... Nah, we're gonna go for the damage. Well, that was unfortunate. Can we cut him? Good. I really didn't want him to throw out a goblet. I'm more worried about the stress than the damage. Really? Come on. You need to be better than that. And people are being slow this turn. That's unfortunate. Oh well. That makes deciding who to kill pretty easy, though. There. No more tempting goblet. And... I'm gonna just go for the stun again. Why not? Heal. Yeah. This works. This works well. We got the 6, so that's very nice. Incision? Not even gonna finish him. There we go, that's better. Pretty heavy debuffs on the Hellion, but that's okay. We can leave the anti-venom behind. Don't care about that at all. Move, please. Ah, money. Take money. And this time we'll go ahead and have the Plague Doctor. Yep. He's a failure. And look at all that stress from that. Ugh. Gross. Well, we may as well bust it open again. Man. Not a whole lot of stuff in those. It's not when you break them open with the shovel. Oh, good. They're surprised. That's fortunate. One guess. Good. Makes this whole thing way easier when that hits. That was probably a bad decision, but oh well. So we've just got the Bone Defender and the other one. Yeah, we'll stick to the stunning strategy. Just don't let him do anything and you'll never have a problem. It's fine. He'll be stunned next round, so we'll have another round to attack him if necessary. We'll go ahead and focus on the Bone Defender. Because now he can feel comfortable throwing out AoE stuff to finish the fight, if we so wish. Divine Comfort for now at 5 hit points back. And that guarantees Bone Defender death, basically. Ah, good. At least somebody hit. Somebody felt like it should actually die.
As victories
not so
mount,
doing so good on the stress so levels back there, resistance. But, oh well. Keep moving. What do we got here? It's a box. What's in the box? Stuff. Yay. More crests. We... Oh, trap. Careful. See, it says trap resist 35%, and then you know, it's just like, I can't take apart traps. I don't understand.
His efficacy on witness
I don't understand. More fighting. And this is what I'm talking about. All three of the rooms have fights in them. Only one showed a fight. It's dumb. Please don't freak out on me back there. Because it's funny, that's why. Ooh, nice. That was solid. Five hit points, so we can probably finish that off. Breakthrough is a bit risky on that front, but yeah, because it's only two or three damage off the breakthrough right now. With all her minus damage nonsense. But a wicked hack, if it hits, finishes it, so I like that. There we go. Ooh, that's important. Now we might be able to finish him with a smite.
Well struck.
Oh, okay. Everybody's just done with this dungeon. They want to get out of here. I'm okay with it. Well, had to daub it up at some point. There we go. I should have thought about that. Maybe tried to get the stress relief somewhere else. Go for a stun. But that's okay. That's
blood.
Okay. I don't want to use up all the food. I don't have anything to really throw away for that cash. Unless I could throw away maybe the holy water? If I do that, I'm going to find something that uses the holy water, and I don't care. Heirloom chest. Let's pop that open. Yay, things. I can't carry any of the things. I don't really need crests very badly. But maybe it... So maybe we just do this. Get rid of the gold we just grabbed. How much do these stack to? I'm not even sure. Maybe it is just 6. And then we leave the crest behind. Got a fight right here. But there might be loot, so it's worth doing the fight instead of walking all the way around, I think. Shouldn't be too bad of a fight either. Oh, he resisted though. That's scary. We'll still go for the blinding gas. I'm not as concerned about it in this fight because this guy, this bone rabble in the back, can't attack from the back. He can't reach that far. He doesn't have any skills. So even though he's stunned, all he would have done was pass anyway. So it was really only a one person stun. But it was still a one person stun and he probably wasn't going to kill anybody anyways. I think we just go for... I kind of wish we could Holy Lance somebody back there, but that's okay. We'll just go for the area of effect damage. That actually worked out reasonably well. Because now this will cycle through their stuns, and I was hoping it would hit his turn fairly early. Because then he would just pass turn and I could safely get some kills. But this works too. Just keep them all stunned while we kill him. We'll just judge you. Since you're going to have to cycle through a stun anyway, there we go. Now we just kill you two. No problem. And do we have anything with a solid crit mod here? You have the highest crit mod. And a skeleton key. And money, but I can't carry either one of throw out the jade. There we go. And we'll just check whatever's here. And I threw out the holy water. See, I'm upset about this because I would love to just toss holy water on it and shove my plague doctor in there and be like, hey, look, minus 20 stress or however much it is. But no, I can't do that because we threw out the holy water. So instead, what I think we're going to do is see if we can get rid of some of these negative effects. There's a chance of getting rid of it, so we'll just go for the stress out. But I think we'll do it on the plague doctor. He's mega stressed anyway and needs to rest no matter what. Yeah, so, but at least we only have him to rest. I still would have loved to have, you know, 40 stress the other direction, all told. But whatever, whatever. I'm upset. Let's be honest. What do we got for stuff? The yips. Oh, that's awful. And then Slayer of Beast. And Faded. Faded is nice. Faded is very nice. And they're both level 3, which was part of the goal. Level 2 up here, level 1 here. That's all. That's all good stuff. We still got a lot of good stuff out of there.
I can still see their angry faces as they stormed the manor.
You know,
but
minor
I was
frustrations
dead before
aside.
They found me. And the letter was on its way.
Looks like nothing too crazy happened in town, and we got our Hellion back. They're back from their drunken bender. Is there anything weird about them? We did have space for them somewhere. Yeah, okay, they're at the top. There we go. Get rid of that. Dud hitter, mercurial. I think they had all those anyway. Still has the bonus stress heal, scouting chance, and max HP though, which is really nice because 40 max HP, let's be honest, it feels pretty huge for a character at this stage of the game. It just feels that way to me. So let's look at what we need to get done around town. We're not going to be diving into a level 3 mission right away because the Dob is all messed up in the head. So we'll figure out somewhere to send him. I think he will only drink, yes. So let's toss him in the tavern. Yeah, get to it. Charlie's still gambling, no point in that. She don't want her to risk any of our items, and she's at no stress anyway, so get her out of there. Let's check the abbey, make sure nobody's hanging out there. Nope, we're good. And so we need to figure out, I think we need to go after that swine prince at this point, if we've got a group for it. But most people are in pretty good shape. I'm just going to load up this screen here, so we can have an easier time arranging a party. I was going to send Talvis after him, because this guy's kind of a beast, if we're honest. No dodge chance, but that's partially because of his equipment. Well, it's almost entirely because of his equipment. He's already been upgraded to level 2 weapon, level 2 armor, upgraded his hue skill. We can upgrade his skills a little more, even, to improve them, but he's pretty powerful. So I think we'll want him as a tank. We'll want our Hellion, who we just got back, as our secondary, as our kind of main damage dealer. Maybe want to change out, get her a new skill instead of Adrenaline Rush, which has its place, but it's kind of, I don't know. It's hard to actually use because, okay, I could get plus 20% damage for, let's say, 3 rounds. 60%, that's a 20% damage increase on those 3 rounds, but it costs 4 rounds to make happen. Or I could have a 25% damage increase, or I guess a 33% damage increase, by just attacking 4 times instead of 3. The math just doesn't add up at this point. Maybe with the accuracy it makes more sense, but it's close, but it's not quite there to me. Even in a boss fight. Maybe we'll check what upgrading it does. Because her accuracies could use a little bit of a boost at the moment. And then I think we might really want something like bleed out. Like let's say I use the damage buff, right? Attack twice with something more basic, like if it bleeds and then wicked hack, both with the damage buff. And then I bleed out and I've got that debuff, which I think lasts for 3 rounds. The minus 20% damage, minus 15 dodge, but I can just buff again afterward and at least waste one of those minus 20%. So maybe if we know we're going after a boss specifically, we get those two skills and we can equip them right before the boss fight and have that instead of like breakthrough or something. So that's a good character to have along. That's the whole point of this whole discussion, is what's a good character to bring along. I think we'll look at taking along Trelly, who has been working out pretty well for us. Maybe he could use Dazzling Light instead of Illumination. What's that? How's that compared to Lovett? Lovett already has the right skills. And not bad stuff here. Maybe we'll take Lovett instead. Trelly has On Guard, which has something to be said for it, but I don't think none of these are particularly great for a boss fight if I'm just looking at it from that perspective. So maybe we'll look at taking Lovett as the healer. And we need one more kind of supporty character. This is really tempting. I haven't really experimented with it too much. So maybe it's not the best idea. But having an accuracy crit buff rolling for the whole fight for my two frontliners in particular, along with spells that focused around bleeding people out, definitely has something to be said for it, I think. I think that would that's a definite option. So yeah, we'll just try out the jester. You know what? We'll try it out. If we lose, whatever. It's a game. Who cares? So yeah, that's what we'll take. So let's look at getting them upgraded as much as we need to. Can we check the blacksmith first? What can we do here? We don't have the deeds to take anything up to rank 3, so that's not important right now. For our leper. What about our leper's skills? He already has Hue upgraded. Maybe we upgrade... Revenge is far more tempting in an actual boss fight that's going to last a while. So maybe we upgrade Revenge, Calamity, and Chop. Just make sure he's good to go. Okay, that'll do for him. Let's look at our Hellion next. We said we wanted these new skills, so this Hellion now has access to all skills. And Breakthrough's already upgraded. Let's upgrade if it bleeds and bleed out and the buff. That's what we were talking about. And we'll go ahead and upgrade Wicked Hack as well. Leave the other two more situational ones unupgraded for the time being. I could have upgraded Training Regimen if I really wanted to. Ooh. Maybe I'm going to spend these.
A strict regimen is paramount if one is to master the brutal arithmetic of combat.
All right, and let's think about what's most important for exactly what we're going to do right now. Not so concerned about upgrading Solemnity anymore for the time being. The buffs get a lot better as they get higher level. Like, that becomes a lot more valuable, for sure. Even though he's losing accuracy, we're already kind of compensating for that. So I think it's okay. So maybe we look into upgrading this buff, and in particular, Chop. Once again, keeping in mind we're going after a boss with this group now. Maybe we upgrade here, the buff again. Keep that accuracy value high. And then the two debuffs we're looking at. Do we go for the single target as well? I think we do. Crit mod 7. It doesn't add any damage, which is unfortunate, but not many of these do, I don't think. And these bleeds could be extremely powerful. Unfortunately, upgrading bleed out doesn't change the damage we do. And we do have to move around in order to be able to bleed out, so that'll need to be considered as well. Maybe we just put the Hellion in the front line? We'll see. We'll see. Now we need to check on our Jester, who I don't think we can upgrade anything because he's resolve level 0. That's the major downside for him right now. And we're going to use Lovett. So yeah, let's upgrade some heals. Ah, those are a little better. Hopefully good enough to matter. We're running low on money, so we won't be able to do much in terms of upgrading weapons and armor, if there's any of that to be done. But I think their weapons and armor were all at least pretty decent, if not the best available to us right now. So we won't worry about that so much. Keep plenty of money around for provisions for next time. We already had paid for de-stressing Dob. Nobody else needs de-stressing. So I think we're going to be good to go to head out after the Swine Prince at the start of the next episode. And that'll do it for this one. So thank you everyone for watching, and I will see you next time.